morning in, 4:23. Not too bad, I don't think. Went to sleep about 10 to 10, 10 o'clock. So I don't think that's too bad going. Kids were out, out like a light by about 9:15. They woke up about 5:15, which is really good. So it is now about 7:20.
You guys are talking.
We've got ready for our first day at Universal Studios. We're going to go and give the new Minions Land a go. And I am like praying that the Jurassic Park tribute store is still open. Finley is dressed as a minion today. So yes, it's going to be a very exciting day. Walked in to the Bayside Diner. Come and get some breakfast for our first day. It's a very funky call in here, absolutely massive. Love, love, love that mural there at the end. And yeah, let's go and see what they've got for breakfast. Kids are starving, as always, when are they never? Here's what they saying is on offer. Ooh. Some pastries over here in the snack, some muffins, a bagel. They've got some Lucky Charms. Ooh. Fruit Loops, Finn. There's some Fruit Loops. Do you want Fruit Loops? No, not this morning. Ooh. So over here then, we've got croissants and things, but if we go up and have a look. That's the menu there. And I've got some yogurt and granola over there. That might be me. This side then. Ooh, breakfast combo. Omelette station, create your own. Hot off the grill, pancakes, French toast. Ooh. What are you having, Jacob?
Some pork sausage.
Some what?
Some pork sausage.
Some pork sausages, yeah.
And then some pancakes.
Pancakes.
And then...
Are you eating like 5 breakfasts this morning? Is that the plan?
Yeah.
He's eating a lot of breakfast, Eddie. Finley, what are you having?
Egg and cheese.
What do you mean you're not sure? You've got pancakes, French toast.
Got pancakes and French toast in there.
They do a Belgian waffle over there as well. They do waffles over here.
The pancake, you can just get.
We can get sausages with the pancake, so you can just get
That's
it all from one place.
That's what I'm having.
Yeah?
I want like sausage
cake. Some breakfast. Okay.
Yeah, they've got waffle, Belgian waffles over there, like breakfast waffles.
Sausage and bacon.
Really? Okay.
I like the bacon.
I don't know whether you like the bacon. You can give it a try. You know, like the crispy bacon? It's like really crispy bacon.
See what, I'll get some on the side of Daddy's.
Ooh, nice. And then around this side, they've got donuts for breakfast.
Donuts,
you can do bread for toast. Ham and cheese croissant, crispy chicken sandwich, vegetarian breakfast pastry. So I've got lots of other stuff around here. Donuts. Goodness, boys, so sorry about this. It's already being demolished. So what we did was we got an adult portion of pancakes and sausage because Jacob wanted pancakes and sausage. He did. Finley wanted bacon and potatoes. So what we did was we got an adult pancake with sausages, a side of bacon and potatoes, so they're kind of sharing that between them, which worked. Marky got a croissant.
Half a croissant.
Show that there, which is now half a croissant.
Is it bacon, an egg? Bacon and egg croissant?
Oui.
Which also came with a side of potatoes, which meant we possibly didn't need the potatoes. But that's a lesson learned. I've got...
Mum, this is boring.
Parfait. It's not boring. It's nice.
I'm on the way to America and you're eating yogurt.
It's boring. It tastes good. Tastes good.
Quite literally sucking back.
Yeah. Kids have also got... Jacob got a bottle of water, a packet of apple slices, packet of apple slices for Finn too, and an apple juice just to get a five a day in because they're going to be eating like this for 3 weeks. And then Marky's got an orange juice. I realised that the Coke machine gave free water after we'd bought a bottle of water, but that's fine because Jake can carry that with him and take it. And where's the receipt, Daddy? So we can... you had the receipt? The lady gave you a receipt?
Get
that
in a second. We'll take a photo.
Get that in a second. I'll take a photo and we'll put it in. But I think it was about $24, was it?
I think it was $23.
$24.50?
No.
What was that wrong?
$42.42.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, I've got no clue. We'll get the receipt out in a minute. So, here's the receipt. We've got it here now.
What was the closest?
It was actually $52.51. Maybe I was definitely wishful thinking with $24.
That was the closest I won.
Excuse me.
We could definitely afford to slim it down.
Oh, we'll definitely slim it down.
I think what we need to do is ask them how many pancakes come with a kids' meal. So if it's only two pancakes, that's probably the right number. And do a kids' meal with sausage. Daddy gets something that's got potatoes on the side. And then the kids just need bacon. And definitely reduce it down. Just figuring out the portion sizes and what everybody's going to eat. I devoured the parfait, I'm not going to lie, it was really nice. It was like a coconut flavour yoghurt with the fruit in it. And then the granola had got like cinnamon in it, so it was really yummy. What do you think, Finn? Was that nice?
I'm going to eat the rest. Eat the rest of it.
He's going to eat the rest.
I've learned that coming here was... No, it was a mistake, at some point it wasn't.
Well, we just got too much food. And I suppose the danger is, on the first day, you're just thinking, I want all the food, I want to try all the food. If you think about it, you two wanted donuts as well. Did never have everything.
Back of the bus.
What school, kids?
You always used to run to get to the back of the bus.
First up of people on the bottom of the bus.
Yeah, you were one of the naughty ones, weren't you? Well, we made it to the bus stop anyway. Now we've got to get through security. And we're here!
I like the
look at that sky. So, we have now sorted out Jacob's accessibility pass. What we did was we came over sort of a good an hour before Universal opens, because early entry was at Islands of Adventure today, but we knew we already wanted to go to Universal, so we decided we'd utilise the guest services queue over there and go and get his accessibility pass sorted. We've also converted our three-part passes into annual passes because we plan on coming back next year, so it makes more sense to do that. And so now we're heading over to Universal. Now, that's Rip Ride Rocket, darling. So in terms of the accessibility pass, it has changed now. Previously, you just used to go and queue at guest services to go and get your accessibility pass. But now you have to fill out an online form for, I will get the details and I will tell you what they are later, because I can't remember the name. It's IBCCES or something like that, but I will tell you later. And you go online and you fill out a form on there, and you have to upload some evidentiary evidence as well as to reason why somebody needs their accessibility pass. So you fill all those details in, put it online, that gets approved, and then Universal, if you list them as one of the parks that you want to get accessibility for, they will get in touch with you, they will email you, they will phone you and discuss the case, and then you will get a case number. It is then when you have that case number that you come into the guest services at the park, and they then will convert and write you out the accessibility pass that you need for in the park. So it makes it easier for the team members here at Universal, and you can get it all done in advance and know that it's sorted. So it's really handy. And it looks like they're letting people in a little bit early, which is always a bonus. So let's go and see now. We've got our annual passes, if there's an exclusive entrance. They let these British crazies in now. That's it. We're inside. It's not open yet, darling, I'm guessing. So then, did you want to go and do the stand in the aircon and go and get the photo pass while we're here? I've been into the photo shop behind me here. So let's see about getting photo pass so that we can get all of our ride photos, and if we have any photos walking around or anything. Handy little tip here about the photo thing. I put on the video about the prices. So for a day it's $109, and then they've got a 3-day and a 5-day, and then you can book a 2-week, and then they've got a year. And the range, and if you're an annual pass holder, for the 2-week one it's like $149, and then the annual is $179. So if you know you're going to come back in the same year, definitely look at, consider getting the annual photo pass. And the other thing to remember is if you've got your photo card from the year before, which we just happen to have it in the lanyard, you actually get it reduced. So we've just got the annual photo pass package for $100. So with tax, it came to $106.49. So bargain, absolute bargain. Points in there. Are you joining the Vicious Six? Or is it Jacob?
Oh, I saw the video.
We've got to watch out for the one person here that might potentially score the most and join the Vicious Six.
Maybe.
That one.
I watch every single video with Venom Cut, so I'm going to cheat.
Oh yeah, there's the gun we're going to use, the Eliminator X.
Don't touch it, don't touch it, Finn, don't touch it.
Come out the ride into a new Minion shop. Oh, I knew somebody was going to be asking for one of those the second we came out here. An Eliminator X, by any chance, Finley Hyde. Ooh, got lots of cool stuff though, haven't they? All the villain con merch. You've been a very bad boy, Daddy. Tough chick, are you doing the face? So Jacob's next request is to go on Transformers, and while we were walking down here, we spotted... It's Bumblebee! Getting his groove on. And now, it's time to go and save the world with the Autobots.
Roger, your front line appraisal stalwart, but removing the Allspark from desk is a high-risk scenario of last resort.
Way to improvise, team. Thanks for being a challenge. Let's head on back to...
Mia's going to go back to her 10-year-old self now, maybe 11-year-old self. Holiday in Spain, when I first got the Jurassic Park book. We were going to go and see the movie when we came back, and I got the book. Going in here. It's still open. I was so panicked that it would be shut before we came to Florida. And it's open. Oh my gosh. It's Sarah! Now, if you also watched a cartoon movie called The Land Before Time, Triceratops were my favourite dinosaur. Sarah! So now we're going in. Bobby's going to be very excited.
He's going to be.
Oh, would he have? Amazing! And it's empty, there's no one in here. Even better.
Oh no, Cruz away.
So look, this is what, when they made the movie, this is the kind of thing that they were working on when they made the movie. Not like computers now, look.
Yeah, it took them ages, didn't it? It took them ages.
It did.
Did you even get the first movie out? Look at the model of the dinosaur.
Oh no. Because they are animatronics, you know that, don't you?
Yeah.
Jake, have you seen the big wooden thing one up here? Look at the T-Rex.
Two are made, one of them got destroyed. The other one's in a museum somewhere in America. I don't know where,
maybe.
Trust me. Just like Google it.
Look at all this over here, look where they've got the recording of the scene, look. Spent hours just looking at it. Oh, there's photos that where they were doing the animatronics and things.
No, and also
screen used stuff.
And also in the showroom, the thing that we found.
Oh, Jacob's found something that he really wants as well. Oh, helmet just fell randomly off the shelf.
So this is a chest, but dinosaur.
He found that dinosaur chest set, which he really likes.
They want it, but sadly...
Well, we haven't got to just buy it right now, have we?
I'm in a crater.
Who's going to sit in a 45? There's nothing going to kill you.
Oh my gosh.
Don't sit in, just sit in a
45. There is. Can you just pick that up, darling? It fell off the shelf.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
No, oh my gosh.
Don't look over there.
The velociraptor there, Jacob. It's not blue.
I can hear it, slap it in the face and it won't kill.
This bit is amazing. There's a Dilophosaurus. Uh oh, Daddy. What are you gonna do? You got your hands up in the air. That's what he does, doesn't he? Ah!
Don't mind Jerry.
You don't mind Jerry?
No,
he's
don't
Jerry,
mind
okay. Yeah, can you have a photo with Jerry in a sec then?
Somebody's trying to mess with my OCD.
Hey?
Somebody's trying to mess with my OCD. And for all you other people out there, watch this. So the green lights.
Yeah.
It's open. It's all the right way. If you get closer, yep. You can see that open is written the right way.
Okay.
Open.
Oh no.
Dun, dun, dun. Wait, don't tell me, they might not know what that means. They might.
Look at that sleeping.
Uh oh. There's a velociraptor. do 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 do
do
do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do do
do do do do
do do do do do do
do do do do do do do do do do do do do
do do
rain jacket, isn't it? Yeah. The little dinosaurs on, it's cool.
$125.
Nothing to see here. Nothing.
Nothing to see. Nothing to see.
You're right, nothing to see. Oh, look like dinosaur poop.
Dinosaur eggs, daddy. Camouflage fudge. Maple vanilla fudge. So yeah, when the movie first came out, these were all the things that were in for sale in the shops. Hmm. So look, you've got trainers,
okay,
lunch boxes, play sets. That was an epic tribute store. Amazing.
Oh, video over there.
Oh, it's Betty Boo. Amazing. Might have to go for another wander around there before we go home. We've got Betty Boo out and Marilyn as well. I don't know what you think. Isn't it really quiet? No, in a good way. Like, 10:05 though, park's been open an hour and it's really nice. Feels quite quiet. There's like lots of space and not hordes of people. I bet it's not like that in Harry Potter, no. John, Ray, Charles. Oh look, Finley's where Finley wants to go. Told you we'd get here eventually. You just have to be patient.
We're coming to do something we've never done before.
We're going to do
the Born Stunt Show. Daddy's wanted to do it for years and we've never done it. So now is the year. There's the car.
Jacob, what did you think of the Bourne stunt show?
Very good, I've got to say.
Oh, I thought it was very
it's
good.
It's teaching you a lie, the story of an expert assassin. When he went rogue, he's actually doing something good, not bad. And the CIA / the FBI are doing something bad, not him. So it's telling you the government can be evil and nice.
Very true, Jacob, very true. But I really like the way that they did it. So you got to see some of the stunt fighting, didn't you? You got to see how they mixed people with videos so it looked real. I definitely recommend doing that. And that's the first time we've ever done it. It was very good. So now, it is 34 degrees. It's getting quite warm. The boys have done really well up until this point. And what we said we didn't want to do was push too hard in this heat so that everybody ends up miserable, crying and fighting and arguing, because then it ruins the whole holiday. And so if we do Fast and Furious and then we're going to go back to the hotel, we're going to jump on the bus, we're going to go back to the hotel, we're going to get our swimmers on, we're going to go and spend the rest of the afternoon in Volcano Bay, I think. So we've stopped for a little liquid refreshment here at Shea Alcatraz, next to our friend Jaws. Kids have had photos, especially Jake, because he's got his Jaws t-shirt on today. We're just waiting on our return time for Fast and the Furious. Just chilling in the shade, hydrating. Because it's important, isn't it, Jacob, that we hydrate in the sun?
Well. Yeah. every like 10 minutes I must have water, I think. Yeah, probably in this.
Make sure we are lobstering. Because as you said earlier,
it feels like 100 degrees.
You've got to look after yourself, haven't you, in this weather, because it's very hot.
And also, the news today is saying it feels like 100 degrees. And if you know, if you've been to Death Valley, you'll be fine with it. But if you haven't, you might struggle with it a bit, because you've never been somewhere that hot before. If you've been to Death Valley, and you're alive, wow.
You're probably used to heat like this, aren't they, yeah? As you can see, we are off to Fast and Furious. Ourselves some food. The kind of thing what we're going to do is get ourselves a decent meal now at lunchtime, and then we can just snack later. Snack. Oh, the guys are outside the mummy. A banana, it's actually banana flavoured popcorn, which may need to be tried. And you've got the Minion Cafe, which is obviously absolutely crackers busy.
New.
It is new, yeah. And you've got the Freeze Ray Pops, where they're doing the ice lollies. So you can get the Minion lolly from Finn. And Bake My Day is the cake shop, isn't it? So it's looking like a good time to head out. Everywhere's getting a bit busy anyway. Despicable Me become a Minion, isn't it, that one? So bye bye Universal for now. See you tomorrow. Yep, we'll go the other side, start the other side tomorrow there, yeah? So the lunch dinner of choice today is Mexican again. So we're gonna go over there to Anton Hito's. He's, as it suggests, a Mexican restaurant. Sit down one, table service. We've eaten here quite a lot. We do like it. Maybe it's not open for lunch. Change of plan. It's not open. It's not open. So, we're gonna go Bubba Gump's. Bubba Gump's is open. Bubba Gump's has been on Marky's list for as many years as I can remember.
Every day is a Fat Tuesday.
Every day is a Fat Tuesday here, but it's not open, so it's not. Even though today is Tuesday. What can we say? So yes, we are going Bubba Gump's instead. You can see just there in the distance. Mark is happy. Ooh. Don't think we need to worry about getting a seat, do we?
Must have drank maybe $15 of peppers.
So, kids, Finley wants corn dog. Corn dog. Meaning corn dog.
Corn dog.
Jacob's going steak. Swapping out the mashed potato for rice. Yeah?
I am having either the shrimp as heaven or coconut shrimp, just out and out. The shrimp as heaven has got fried shrimp, coconut shrimp, so I get a bit of both. Tempura shrimp.
Mm.
Yeah, buddy.
I think I'm joining Jacob with the whole steak. Oh, I really do quite like the sound as well, the Texas chicken sandwich. So I might do that.
It's just that it. I don't really want fries. We eat fries with bloody everything.
No, I don't
so.
Want fries. That's why I was kind of like on the steak with the mashed potato.
Potato. Shrimp is heaven for me. Can't go wrong with a bit of shrimp.
Still trying to understand how broccoli can be 300 calories.
Maybe the butter. The broccoli's about 7 and they're putting 2
So we've done a pretty terrible job here because they've already started eating again before I've even got the camera out. So Finley went for the corn dog nuggets, which he has devoured. There's only 2 left.
There's 3.
And he had his with... Oh, there's 3. He's got 3 left. He had that with fruit and he's got jelly as well. Nice. Jacob went for his steak. We've got broccoli, which is currently on my plate, but he's got broccoli and they swapped it out for steamed rice to make Jacob happy. Daddy then got his shrimp, harvest shrimp, everything shrimp, whatever it was called, shrimp heaven. So he's got coconut shrimp, tempura shrimp, fries and lots of different sauces.
Fried shrimp as well.
Saucy. And I went for the Texas barbecue chicken burger and I swapped my fries for mashed potato and mashed potato. Where am I from? Mashed potato. That looks really good. So let's dig in. So we've made it back to Cabana Bay after our meal at Bubba Gump's. Daddy, how would you rate your meal at Bubba Gump's?
Very good. Anyone tempted to try the shrimp, I would recommend having the shrimp.
Heaven.
That's all. It's very good. Lots of, if you like 3 different dips, like a tempura dip. Can't remember what the other 2 were, but they were nice. But you get a little bit of a mix. I think if you went with just, if you like coconut shrimp, there's some coconut shrimp in it, but just enough, because I think there'd be too much coconut shrimp on the coconut. Well, that sounds really stupid, but yeah. Unless you can stomach probably 12 pieces of coconut shrimp, which I think could be quite sickly.
Yeah.
Try the shrimp heaven, because it's very nice.
Out of 5? Like,
5.
Yeah. There we go. So I had the Texan chicken burger. Had like a spicy mayo on it, some salad, grilled Cajun chicken, pepper jack cheese, some crispy bacon. And I'm going to say it was really nice. And I exchanged it out for the mashed potato. And the mashed potato alone was a 5 out of 5.
What was in it?
I think it's just bits of the skin, I don't know. It's like...
It was nice.
Mashed potato here is the best mashed potato. It doesn't matter what we do at home. You can never get the mashed potato the same.
Unless you put butter and cheese in it, then it gets good.
So, yeah, I don't quite know what they put in it, but it tastes really good. Which means it can't be good for you. But yeah, well, I think I would rate the burger a good, solid, as far as burgers go, to chicken burgers go, to be fair, I probably would, as a 5 out of 5 from a chicken burger standpoint. In terms of meals and food, probably a good 4. Strong 4. Your food at Bubba Gump's, out of 5. Yeah. How much are you giving it?
4 out of 5.
4 out of 5 for Finn?
4.
Jacob's a 4 as well. What was the reasoning for a 4, Finn?
It's because what I didn't like and I don't know what it was.
Right, okay. And what was your reason for a 4, Jacob?
Because the rice wasn't properly chopped up into pick little pieces. And also the steak.
Yeah.
Taste was a lot tougher to get your fork in. Oh.
Yep.
There you go, that's the kids' reasonings for their writings anyway. We're now back up to the room. Are we going to get changed?
Go to the volcano.
We're going to go and hit the volcano.
Yeah, and I'm going to go on the big boy slides because I'm 7 years old.
What about you, Jacob? Are you going on some?
Mate, it depends.
One thing to be said about any of it, it'll depend on how busy it is as to how many slides you're getting on, to be fair, but we'll see. We'll see what we can tapu-tapu. Either way, we can play in the wave pool. We can play on the... in the lazy river. So we're back in the room. Done a quick phone call home. Say hello to the doggies and everyone. And now... we're going to venture downstairs to Volcano Bay. Now, I can record a little bit as we walk in, etc, etc, but you're not really allowed to take the stuff around because you can't take cameras on any of the slides. Yes, we could take the GoPro around in the lazy river, but you've seen so many videos of people doing that. It seems a bit of a pointless thing to do. So, but what we will do is we'll give you some ideas of our favourite slides when we come back, and we'll give you a bit of a lowdown on it in that sense, because it does look very busy from where we are right now because of how hot it is. So I imagine we could be waiting around a little bit and spending lots of time in the wave pool and in the lazy river.
They might want to zoom downstairs because people are coming back in.
They're not coming back in, dude. If they're anything, they're leaving. They've been there all day, but we're going down there now for a couple of hours because we can literally walk out the back of a hotel straight in. So this is our tower here.
88.
This is beachside.
Beach.
So we should come out the double doors and follow this path down and round. And you can see the little sign here says resort guest entrance. So the beauty of this location, if you just follow this path, this walkway, into Volcano Bay, which is literally just behind that green scrub there. So you walk all that path, all the way along to the Bayside Tower.
That is the exact same one as ours, but
And then you walk round here, and you follow the path across the road and into Volcano Bay here through the resort guest entrance. It literally took maybe 2.5 minutes,
maybe three,
from our tower.
Yeah, resort guest entrance.
So there we go, through security and follow this path down, around, and then you're in. Now, any of you know the whole parking at the parking at Universal and then waiting to get on a bus to get here? Oh, it's really not fun. This way, so much easier. We have it. We're here. So if you've never been before, when you go through the gate, it's okay. When you go through the gates and you like go in with your tickets, you get given something called a tapu tapu, which is one of these. It's like a little smart device which enables you to tap in and out the queues for the rides to stop you from having to stand in a physical queue. So it's a bit like a virtual queuing tool. So you tap in for the one ride that you want, it'll give you your return window, your time amount of time so you can return. And then in between that, you can go on anything that doesn't require a tap in. So that could be the Lazy River, the Marky Darling, the lockers are there. Yeah, so it could be the Lazy River, you can go in the wave pool. If some of the slides now say ride now, you can go on those. So anything that says a ride now, you can just get on it and get in the queue. But anything else you need to tapu in for, you tap. So here, just to show you. There you can see right now. These are the things that you can enjoy anytime. Those that have got... So as we've come in that way then, we turn left. We're walking through the marketplace. And this is where you'll find the lockers. And the toilets. Huh? Over there. So this is where we're going to leave you for now. While we go and enjoy some rides. So we're just walking back to Cabana Bay after some couple of hours playing at Volcano Bay. It was busy. We got to go on one slide, which was good, and then the kids just enjoyed playing in the wave pool and in the kiddies play area. And that was what we did really, but we still had a good time for a couple of hours. We're now going to go and get ourselves an ice cream from the shake place here at Cabana Bay. So, let's go. From shakes. So, let's look at these flavours that we've got here. So we brought our ice cream back outside because it's a bit warmer outside because we're a bit wet, the air con's making the kids cold. Got a two scoop with, well, two small scoops, banana pudding and chocolate cookie dough, chocolate chip cookie dough. Jacob got cookies and cream ice cream cone. I've got salted caramel truffle with banana pudding. Marky's got a grown-up milkshake. Yeah, the banana Foster's, which is salted caramel truffle ice cream with banana pudding and rum. Bit of rum.
Rum? What is rum?
Alcohol. Grown-up milkshake, not for kids. Not for kids.
How